Hey, ratty boy, you thought I'd leave you on YouTube all by yourself? I figured you would miss me too much. And it looks like, at least based on your social media, that you should be in a tight spot, or what would normally be a tight spot for a rat. Paul Saladino, Carnivore MD, better known as Rat Boy, for his appearance as well as behavior, a face that literally looks like a rat. And he always goes for the cheese, aka Money Moolah. January 29th, the rat is doing a live update on Instagram speaking about how he caught COVID. 2 days later, is using COVID to push his astroturfing supplement company. On February 6th, less than 1 week after being sick, he's seen in Tanzania, so proud to be taking pictures next to a tribe. Does it look like he's wearing a mask to you? Does it look like he's standing 6 feet apart to you? It's questionable. And bringing your rat shit supplements to an indigenous tribe is like bringing a fleshlight to your girlfriend's house, although you would probably need to bring an anal version and a beard to put on the girl, if it was a girl in the first place. Maybe you should send me some pictures of you anal swabbing those African boys so I can put them up on your website, paulsaladino.com. So what's the deal, Paul? What's your explanation for this one? That the tribesmen are so
metabolically healthy, they would survive at a 100% rate.
As with everything else, he's just gonna ignore me and use his Freemason connections to continue to pad his wallet as well as his Freemason daddies. I mean, he either believes in you know what or he doesn't. If he didn't believe it was real, that would explain this behavior. Either way, this looks horrible. You can't play both sides of the coin. You can't pretend it exists and then say, oh, I got sick, and then go travel. Like, it doesn't make any sense. What makes it even more comical is that he has spent the last 3 months traveling. Puerto Rico! Hey, listen, I love those Puerto Rican girls. I mean, well, he's not into girls. Montana, Utah, Africa, back to Virginia. Is this guy trying to spread to everyone on this planet? You guys saw the new Borat movie, right? If you didn't watch it, they're very funny and it lines up with this. Maybe he's just trying to probe as many boys as possible. Hey, you know what, Rat Boy? Maybe you should take a trip to this tri-state area and we can visit one of your buddies' ashes in Jersey. I'm sure Mr. Crowley would love to see us both for different reasons. You know what this reminds me of? I think this was from a Family Guy episode. There was this guy, Sir Richard Francis Burton, who traveled around to measure men's junk. He was fascinated by African phallic worship, and he had a strange, old school, racist obsession with the size of black men's penises. He even went so far as to measure several obliging fellows. I wonder if that's what Rat Boy's up to. Hey, you never know. As much as I enjoy joking around and pointing out how much of a clown this guy is, you guys know from past videos, the many I've done on this degenerate, how upset I've actually been. And I cannot explain how frustrating it is to work so hard for something and have these Freemason loser plants. Plant as in they put him there to specifically steal my information and make a whole bunch of people who think they're better than me and you a lot of money. Apparently not, if they can't think of anything themselves and they need to steal other people's research. What do you need all that money for? To guarantee a single life of homosexual luxury into old age? Apparently, the rat isn't too happy that I insinuated he was performing anal swab tests on African boys in a previous video because he called his lawyer to also issue a summons against my meat company, Frankie's Free Range Meat. I mean, does he really think he's gonna shut me up with these nonsense, frivolous lawsuits? I think it's very clear you want me to stop talking, so I suggest you take a long trip back to reality and stop burning that money in your lawyer's driveway. You're what? 40 years old, no girlfriend, dancing with dudes in saunas? Are you just a closet homosexual that wants to take pretty old Frankie boy on a date? There's a long line for that one, buddy, And considering your experience in anal swabbing in those saunas, I figured you would be a perfect candidate for performing those tests in Africa. I mean, I haven't seen any mention of formal training to perform an anal swab test, so they probably put you at the front of the line for your lifelong experience. And Paul, if I'm telling the truth, you can't really win a lawsuit, you know? If half the stuff I say is the truth and half the stuff I say is me implying a joke, I mean, I guess you could spend all the money on lawyers you want. Have fun in the sauna with your gay boy Mason buddies.